So, hi, my name is Julia Mujica, and this is Lina Bautista, and we are here to present you our demo research titled wAIggledance, Music by Swarm Intelligence. And just to give you a little bit of context, I am currently doing my PhD at the UPC in collaboration with the Universitat de Barcelona and under a project that is funded by the Ministry of Education. And I received a scholarship from the Council of Science and Technology of Mexico. So a lot of entities involved. And so what I work in my PhD is the topic of animal collective behavior from a statistical physics and complexity science perspective. Basically, what we want to understand a little bit better is how individuals interact with each other to create such a complex behavior like the one that we can see here, no? Like flocks of birds or schools of fish or swarms of ants or of honeybees. And there's a lot of information happening in the interaction between them. In this example, for example, there's like three things that I can notice very quickly. Like they are trying to maintain a certain distance, they are trying to equal their speed, and they are trying also to synchronize their direction of motion. No? So basically it's how these rules of interaction result or allow for the emergence of a complex behavior. Next. Specifically, we are working on with David March, that is a master's student of the UB, myself and Carmen Miguel, that she's a professor at the UB in the Faculty of Physics, and she's also my supervisor. And we're working on a topic of collective decision-making in honeybees when they are deciding a new nest site. No? When they have to change because they grow too much, they need to split, the colony splits, and then a cluster of bees go and look for another potential site to nest. And very quickly, how they do this, it's a very beautiful and surprising mechanism because some scouting bees leave the cluster and go look in their surroundings to look for potential places. No? And then they come back and they perform a dance, or what we as humans call dance, that is called the wAIggledance. And you can see it here in this video, like this. The wAIggledance. wAIggledance, yeah. And you can see here, this bee is performing it. And all the other bees are like kind of watching the dance. Because in that dance, there's encrypted information about the quality, the subjective quality of the site they saw, and the location of the place, no? So other bees watch this dance, and then they go and check this place out, and then come back and dance for it again, until the consensus is reached. Everybody agrees that there's a better place, there's like the highest quality place, and they go all there and start nesting there. So there's obviously tons of models about this and a lot of theory. And one of the theories indicates that why they reach consensus is because honeybees tend to dance longer for places that they think are higher quality. So that difference, that temporal difference makes all the difference. And what we're trying to do in my research group is to implement a model, but in robots, which are the ones that we have here, and to try to understand how much a honeybee, how many honeybees a honeybee has to watch and gather information from the cluster to decide what site to dance for, or to go and check out and then come back and dance for it. So, well, we have here a simulation that is only to prove like how little by little in time they end up dancing for the good site, no? For the site of high quality. Next. So with this in mind, we decided to use this very, very cute from the outside, but very devilish from the inside, robots. And they are called the kilobots. And they were created in 2012 in Harvard to perform swarm intelligence tasks, no? So collective tasks or shape formations or to study collective behavior. And they are very, very small. They are 3 centimeters long in diameter. And they have an Arduino heart. And they can exchange information with neighbors in a 10 centimeters radius. It's perfect for our research because it's actually looking at local interactions and how that creates a much more complex or a consensus reaching, no? In our case. And they also move with two vibrating motors that they have on the side, and that makes the legs vibrate. And they are very scalable, so that means that we program them with this controller here, that via infrared, they send the program to all the kilobots, so you don't have to program each one one by one, but you can like do a bunch of them at the same time. And they also have a LED light to indicate their internal state. Did you put the videos? The controller sends the... That you can see the controller there. It's the one that sends the program via infrared, and they also communicate with neighbors via infrared. So you need a specific surface that is glossy to reflect. Next. Well, when we started the research, obviously, as all research, it was like, this is perfect. We're gonna be using these kilobots very easily, and of course not. It's never like that. And in research, you always find bumps. And our current bump is that we realized that kilobots have an internal clock that depends on the processor speed. And that makes it very difficult to synchronize if they don't communicate. Even if they communicate, it's very difficult to synchronize them. You can see here, no? Like they have the time. They count time in a thing that is called kiloticks, because in kilobots everything is kilo leaf, kilo ticks, kilo everything. And you can see here that for 100 kiloticks, maybe for the kilobot Lina, it's 5 seconds, but for kilobot Julia, it's 6 seconds, no? It means 6 seconds, because my processor is slower than Lina's, no? So, yeah, that makes a lot of things very difficult. But when I was testing algorithms to try to synchronize them, Lina got super excited, and Lina is the actual artist and musician of this duo, so she could see things that I couldn't. And she said, like, why don't we sonify your attempts to synchronize the kilobots, no? And I was like, okay, let's try that. And it's a very nice way of listening how synchronized are they, and they are normally not. And we started recording the algorithms that I'm trying out and see how they sounded, no? And it turns out it's pretty fun and it's illustrative. I don't know. The next one. So today we're gonna test 3 swarm algorithms. The first is we're gonna force 2 leaders to try to synchronize their neighbors. Like, we're gonna tell the leaders, tell the others that they have to submit to your desires, which is not actually self-organization. And they're gonna compete for attention, and they have 2 different rhythm patterns. So maybe you'll notice, maybe you'll not, because they do whatever they want, so let's see. And then we have the second one that is actually a modified version of an example algorithm of synchronization that looks like fireflies synchronizing their light, but they are motionless, and they are put in very specific places so they all communicate, so it's pretty easy if you do it like that, but if you want them to move, and that makes it completely different. So We decided to do this and complicated a little bit more, putting two oscillation periods of turning their light and moving. And let's see how that sounds. And they go through periods of more synchronization and less synchronization. It's nice. And the third one that I think it's the one that is going to win at the end, I hope. What I'm doing is to put temporal leaderships in time in different parts of the space, and they like say, "Hey, let's restart our clock," and they do like a wave of to all the kilobots. No, like I tell Lina, Lina tells the guy over there tells that other guy, and everybody starts to say, "Ah, I'm gonna reset my clock," like a wave, exactly. And that doesn't work still, but I'm trying, and this is basically our experimentation with these three algorithms. So now I'll give you Lina, so she can tell you more about the sound.
Yeah, hi. Yeah, as Julia says, I am a musician. I am Lina Bautista, musician, and I also work with music technologies from, I don't know, a long time now. So we started to talk with Julia about all this research, and we thought, like, how about making a robot party, no? and it's begin like a joke, but it get more serious when I knew that these kilobots can be done by yourself, like do-it-yourself kilobots. So we are kind of trying to make our own. These are ours. These are UV from the UV. But we are trying to make ours. So that was the first challenge. We already are working on that. And the other challenge was to try to make this more musical. Also, like trying to find ways to work with rhythms and with patterns. So we developed together, I think, one of these synchronization, like to make it more musical. And the next challenge was to make also more musical, not only with they like moving, but also with another instruments. So I decided to use the modular synthesizers to work with them. At the first time, actually, we tried to use a camera to try to see how they move or
the color
and more like we fancy stuff, to map the things and the movements. But then actually we realized that the movement was already there with the sound of they moving. They move like with this vibration. So they produce already sound. So we, at the end, we use this sound as source for the data for sonify them. No? So at the end, what I did was to, I don't know if this is sounding already, I put a contact microphone. It's not that fancy as it seems. So it has a piezo there, a contact microphone. So with the movement, we are going to change some of the things in the modular synthesizer. So one thing is that they as they move, they sound. So I have like a reverberation there, so I can change that. And also the interesting thing is that I also use this with a trigger. So they trigger some kicks and also some synthesizers. We'll see. But the movement is that makes all the rhythms and the sounds. And also, and I like that a lot, is that with this module that is an input, we can send CV, controlled voltage signals. So they also changing all the filters and the things that are happening right now. So they are in charge of all the things. So I think we can
start,
and stop talking and show you how they do the robot party.
Thank you for the kind clap.
Thank you.
Thank you for listening.